What is up, ninjas? My name is Sam World, and in today's video, I'm going to be telling you guys why your leads are sounding thin. So if you have that question, you've been getting that a lot as feedback from labels, and that is the one thing holding you back. In today's video, I'm going to answer that question for you. Why are they sounding thin? Now, if you just want the answer, it's because you don't have enough mids in your leads. And if you want to see why, then join me. As always, if you want to support my channel, make sure to head over to evosounds.com. Now, in front of us, guys, here we have a note frequency chart, physics of music notes and whatnot. I don't know what's the science behind it, but the important thing for you to understand is the fact that a lot of you guys, when you play your leads at, let's say, optimal range, not too high and not too low, but just in the sweet spot where a lot of you progressive house guys land your leads or your big room guys, a lot of the times you're playing in the fifth area. So you're playing from C5 all the way up to, let's say, C6. Now, if you notice that frequency range is going to range from 523 all the way up to 1,000. Now, if you go inside of Ableton, and here I have a lead that I've made thin on purpose. A lot of you guys will put OTT on leads, and that's another reason why they sound thin. But the reason they sound thin is because OTT gives you a lot of brightness, but it also dampens those mids a bit too much. So here's this lead that I have, and we'll play it in the C3 area. Okay, now if we go back to the note frequency chart we were talking about, as we stated before, a lot of the power from your leads are going to come from this area here, like let's say the 500 range and up. So if I wanted to increase the body on this, then I can go in Audition. Now I'm hitting D, so I'm gonna go and use this, and it's around 587 that my fundamental, you could say, is gonna be at. So we're gonna move that to 587. And there it is. Now I'm gonna leave it there and pull it back down. Now whenever you're doing boost, guys, a lot of times you want more broader boosts. They're a little bit more musical and they sound a lot better than going super surgical on it. Plus you wanna, again, extend that area up because you're not just gonna be playing D, obviously. You're gonna be playing D and D sharp. I know how you guys are. So what we're gonna do again here is just have it around that area. Now if I get rid of that, very thin, we bring it up. Now we can go a little higher. And that's what we're gonna get out of it. So let's see, get rid of it. So a little bit more body brought into it. Now, let's see, maybe I'm playing an octave higher than that. So maybe I need to go up to the D6. So that's 1,174. So I'm gonna move that to 1,100 as it doesn't give me anything, 1,100, yep. So now, if we get rid of it, we're bringing a lot of life back into the lead that was lost again with that OTT. Now, again, this problem shouldn't arise with OTT if you're using it on the correct leads, you know, leads that can be super compressed. But you can always, again, pull this out as well. Now, if I'm playing, let's say, here, which this is going to be more of the range that most people play in, again, big room and progressive house. And again, we just move that back to 500. And I'm playing around the D area, D sharp, like you stamped, guys. And around 581 is where the D should be, the fundamental of it, the 587. So again, just by doing that, now get rid of it. You can't see the difference. So that is the answer to the question. You just don't have enough mids. And again, it all depends what octave range you're playing your leads where you're going to be doing that boost if your leads sound thin. Now, the problem with me teaching this to you is the fact that I'm scared that you guys are going to overdo it. Like, you're going to pull this shit up and going to go Elon Musk to Mars now instead of the moon. And again, to me, that's just scary because then it's going to sound like this. Which, you know, what doesn't sound that bad. But you know what? If you already have enough mids, then it starts sounding a little bit like, you know, you fattened the lead up too much and now we got a little belly, you know what I'm saying? However, you want to be fit. You want to have the six pack on it. So just make sure you have a bit of balance. You know, there's those guys that lift weights and they think they need to eat to build muscle. And they overeat and just get fat with muscle. And then they lose weight and they get super skinny. So you get the idea there, guys. But again, the answer to that question is going to be you don't have enough mids in your leads. Now, let's say you do have enough mids and they're still sounding thin. Then at that point, it's probably due to the balance of your track. So you either have too much low end and mid lows. Something's masking your leads. So from there, you're going to have to go, Sherlock Holmes on that and figure it out. But hopefully this helps a lot of you guys out. Make sure to be on the lookout for that if you ever feel like your leads sound thin or you get that as feedback. And I'll catch you guys next time for another video. You guys take care and much love. Peace out.